Your Excellency, Yun Mosung, Minister of Trade, Industry and Energy, distinguished business leaders, friends, a very good afternoon. I am delighted to meet you all today in Seoul. This is my third interaction with the Korean business leaders in the span of just 12 months. This intensity is international. I wish to see more and more Korean business turning their attention to India. Even when I was the Chief Minister of the state of Gujarat, I traveled to Korea. Korea was and still remains a role model of economic growth for me. Friends, India today, a country of 1.25 billion people, is going through a great transition. It is changing from an agriculture-dominated economy to an economy led by industry and services. An economy that is close to one that is globally interlinked. An economy that is known for its red tape to one known for a red carpet. India has emerged as a land of opportunities. While we work for realizing the Indian dream, we seek like-minded partners, and among them we see South Korea is truly a natural partner. India-Korea business relations have come a long way in past decade, and especially closer in the last few years. India is among top 10 trade partners of Korea, and India is the sixth largest export destination for Korean goods. Our trade volume has reached $21.5 billion for the calendar year 2018. The negotiation to upgrade comprehensive economic partnership agreement have been fast-tracked to achieve the bilateral trade target of $50 billion by 2030. Not just trade. In investment terms also, we are seeing a positive turn. And Korean investments into India have reached a cumulative figure of almost $6 million. Friends, after my visit to Korea in 2015, we have launched a Korea-specific facilitation cell called Korea Plus to guide, assist, and handhold investors during the entire life cycle of the business. Hyundai, Samsung, LG Electronics have become trustworthy brands in India. And KIA is soon to join this club. over 600 Korean companies have invested in India. And we aspire to welcome many more. And to ease your path, visa on arrival for Korean nationals has been put in place since October last year. We encourage the presence of Korean trade office in India. And I'm glad that we recently had the sixth office of KOTRA open in Ahmedabad. And that is my hometown. Let me tell you a little more about what is happening in India now. The fundamentals of our economy are sound. We are well set to become a $5 trillion economy in the near future. No other large economy in the world is growing at over 7% year after year. Hard policy decisions, such as the introduction of goods and service tax, have been taken. In the last 4 years, we have jumped 65 places in the World Bank's Ease of Doing Business ranking to 77th. And we are determined to move into the top 50 next year. We are one of the most open countries for foreign direct investment today. More than 90% of our sectors are now on automatic route for approval. As a result of this, and the confidence in India, we have received FDI worth over $250 billion over the past 4 years. Friends, in India, we are also focused on making our growth inclusive. It is for this reason that we have taken strong initiatives for financial inclusion. In the course of the past 3 years, we have opened over 300 million bank accounts for those who never had a bank account. Now, 99% of Indian households have a bank account, and more than $12 billion have been deposited in these accounts. They now have access to affordable pensions and insurance. Under the Mudra scheme, we have extended microcredit worth more than $90 billion to 128 million persons over the past 3 years. 74% of these loans have gone to women. We have leveraged the power of a biometric identity system, bank accounts, and mobile phones to deliver subsidies and services to the previously unbanked. Government benefits worth more than $50 billion are now transferred directly to the beneficiaries, thus removing leakages. We have taken huge strides in rural electrification. India is now recognized by the International Energy Agency as one of the greatest success stories in bringing about rural access to energy in 2018. in renewable energy. We have become the sixth largest producer in the world. These and our initiatives of the International Solar Alliance will enable India to be a pioneer in moving in the direction of a green global economy. That is our commitment to a green and sustainable future. Through these steps, the way of life of our people in all corners of the country is being transformed. It's totally transformed. This in turn is transforming governance and public service. Friends, economic progress is closely tied to world-class infrastructure, be it transport, power, ports, shipbuilding, housing, and urban infrastructure. There is huge demand in India, while there are strong technological capabilities and capacities in Korea. We estimate the investment requirements in infrastructure at over $700 billion by 2022. Under the Sagarmala project, port projects involving investment of over $10 billion have been identified for award in the upcoming 5 years. It is essential to guide the growth of urban utilities and create smart cities which ensure sustainable and clean future for all. More than 500 million of India's population will be urban by 2025, and this opens the scope for cooperation in building smart solutions in India. Recognizing the importance of supporting India's infrastructure development, India and South Korea have identified $10 billion under Korea's Economic Development Cooperation Fund and export credit to finance such projects. While aiming for fast economic growth, India is also rooted in the principles of ensuring sustainable economic growth. For example, in automobile sector, the National Electric Mobility Mission aims for affordable and efficient electric vehicles. South Korea, being a leading manufacturer of electric vehicles, has a huge opportunity in this sector in India. Friends, research and innovation would be the driving force in the fourth industrial revolution era. And we do understand that the role of government is to provide the support system. In this regard, we have introduced flagship programs, Startup India, with $1.4 billion fund for 4 years to create a startup ecosystem in India. Under the able leadership of President Moon, South Korea has also unveiled a program to spend $9.4 billion by 2020 in a bid to increase capital supply for startups and venture-friendly environment. This synergy in policy and this synergy in policy regime is a reflection of areas of common interest for both India and Korea. Our vision of an India-Korea startup center will provide a hub for Korean startups and Indian talent to freely communicate. South Korean National IT Industry Promotion Agency has already opened their Indian office in Bangalore to facilitate Korean startups to India. In the field of innovation, both countries have decided to establish India-Korea Future Strategy Group, an India-Korea Center for Research and Innovation Cooperation, to provide an institutional framework for future-oriented cooperation based on research, innovation, and enterprises. Friends, it is our earnest desire to work with the Republic of Korea more closely to realize the dream of our citizens. Efforts by the governments will not be realized unless business leaders like you share the same dream. I would like to conclude here with Korean expression. Hunja Khamyon Palli Khajiman.
If you walk alone, you can go fast, but if you go together, you can go far away. That was a Korean expression.
I entirely agree with its meaning that you would go fast if you go alone, but you would go far if you go together. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, His Excellency.